Did you know that 88% of people who track their food on a food tracking app such as MyFitnessPal were found to lose weight when they did it for just 7 days? Stay tuned to find out why I feel food tracking is one of the most important things to lose weight and why MyFitnessPal is one of my favorite apps to use. Hi. I'm Dr. Shauna, and welcome back to another video. To make sure you don't miss any of my new uploads, hit the subscribe button, click the bell to be notified every time a new video is uploaded. Tracking your daily food intake is one of my top recommendations for anybody trying to lose weight. I feel this way for a couple reasons. The first one is if you are tracking every single thing that you put in your mouth, it is going to make you hold yourself accountable for everything you eat. So I'm talking not just meals or snacks. I'm talking about those three M&Ms you snitched from your kids, that cookie you took two bites of, all of those things you're going to want to track every single time you put them in your mouth. Because then the next time you go to snitch a few M&Ms, you're going to think about, do I really want to get my daily calories from these M&Ms, or do I want to wait and save that for a more nutrient-dense food? The best way to track your foods is to use an app. This way, the app will determine the amount of calories per serving, the amount of fat, saturated fat, unsaturated fats, sugar, fiber, carbs, everything. It's going to be able to track all of those things for you. So then you're not only going to be able to track how many calories you're taking in with your food every day, but you're also be able to see how much of that is sugar, how much of that is carbohydrates, how much of that is bad fats instead of good fats, and kind of keep yourself accountable to what you're actually putting in your mouth. So the best app that I have found to use is going to be MyFitnessPal. So the rest of this video, I want to kind of just go through why I feel like MyFitnessPal is the best tracking app for me, and I feel like it would be for everyone else. So after you download the MyFitnessPal app on your phone, you then will put in all your information. Obviously, you're going to put in your name, you'll put in your current weight, your height, your sex, and then what your goal weight is going to be. It's also going to allow you to choose how many pounds a week you want to lose. Typically, they like for you to stay between 1 and 2 pounds because that's what they consider a healthy weight loss per week. Not to say you can't lose more than that, but that's really where your goal should be. The slower and more gradual you lose the weight, so the easier it is to keep off. So if you lose 5-10 pounds in a week, sometimes that's just water weight. So a good rule of thumb is you're just really to be losing weight that's like fat that you want to lose and keep off, about 2 pounds a week is going to be a good goal to keep towards. So once you get into that, then every single day you can track your food. So you can see, I'm going to open up the app, and when you go in here, you can hit add. And when you hit add, then you're going to be able to see where you can choose food, water, exercise. So I'm going to check food. And then when you go to food, then you're going to either put in like your breakfast, your snack, your lunch, or your dinner. So let's do like a breakfast. And for breakfast, I typically eat my chia fruit and nut bowl. And so I already have it saved in there. So I can pull it up, the ingredients that are in there, and it's going to show the oat milk, the chia seeds, the honey, the walnuts, and the raspberries. So it has it all added together, and I have it set to what one serving would be. And so then I'm going to add that, and then you'll see it. It's going to put it up on there, and it'll show that in my food for my breakfast. All right, the other reason why I love MyFitnessPal is you can actually track foods that aren't like actual foods that you look up. So say, for example, you want to eat a can of chicken noodle soup like this. So this can of chicken noodle soup, I can look up on the app. So you're going to go again back into your app. You're going to add the food, and then you choose, say, this what you wanted to eat for lunch. So you're going to add that in, and then you're going to click on where it says barcode. So you hit barcode, and then you're going to turn, and you're going to look, and you're going to scan the barcode in that square where the barcode goes. And then once it's scanned, you'll see it's going to pop up and give you the information on it. And you're gonna make sure that you choose the serving size that you ate. You can have one serving, or if you eat the whole can of soup, then that would be two servings. So make sure you're putting the correct servings that you had so you're tracking it correctly. Another thing for the barcodes that I really like is if you buy like pre-made food, like from the grocery, or God forbid you get it from like a convenience store or a gas station, what have you, as long as it has a barcode, you can scan it in the app. So say this sandwich that I got from the grocery, that's pre-made chicken salad sandwich on this, it's like, I think it's Hawaiian bread and it's got lettuce in there. And so all I have to do is go back in the app and use that barcode scanner and it's gonna pull it right up. So here, I'm gonna show you how you go in there. You go back, add food, lunch, barcode, scan the barcode, and then boom, it's right in there. So as you can see, it's really easy to add any food that you want. So other than the ease of use of this MyFitnessPal app that I love, you can see it's very user-friendly. The other thing I really like is I can actually sync it to my Apple Watch. So you can sync it to your Apple Watch, Fitbit, Garmin watch, any kind of smartwatch that you have that's gonna track your steps every day. And then in the app, it's going to have that sync in there and show how many calories you have burnt and exercise based on your steps that you're tracking on your smartwatch. The other good thing is you can track your water. Now, I talked in my last video about my 5 secrets to weight loss, and water was one of them, and it's a huge one. And the best way to hold yourself accountable and make sure you're getting enough water in is to track it. So you can go into the app. Again, you're going to hit the add, choose water this time instead of food or exercise, and then you put how many fluid ounces of water that you drink at each time, and you continually will go in and can add it. So then this way it's going to allow you to see, am I getting that half of my body weight in ounces of water a day? So the biggest thing and the toughest thing to do with this app, I would say, would be being consistent. It's super easy to put the stuff in, but it's really easy to just say, oh, I'll do it later. But let's be real. I can be honest. I want you to be honest too. We always have our phone on us. Like seriously, it's somewhere near you every time you eat. So it's really easy. You eat, you get in the habit, you pick up your phone, you track your food every single day. So if you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. I hope it has helped you get some ideas of how to use MyFitnessPal app and why you definitely want to start using this, especially if you're trying to lose weight. And as always, remember, healing starts from within.